Hey everyone, Armando here, and welcome to Servant Leadership. What we are going to cover in this short tutorial is I'm going to give you a walkthrough of the new HALO system. For many of you, this might be the first course you take on HALO, or if you've already got some experience, I'm going to show you where I will be posting all of the pertinent information inside of my course, so it's much easier for you to navigate. So you want to go ahead and make sure that you watch this video from start to finish so you can jump into the course and begin with our classroom introductions in the classroom discussion area. Now, what you want to make sure that you do, and let me go ahead and bring this up on the screen, is you want to make sure that you subscribe to my channel and also hit the notifications bell. Why? Because I will be doing weekly videos, weekly tutorials, weekly sample paper videos that are going to help you inside of your assignments. So what should you do as a student? Watch these videos from start to finish. Look at the paper format. Look at the content. I've been doing this for a long time, and students who follow the blueprint, because success leaves clues, are much more successful in this course. The course becomes more enjoyable, and I cut down less of your time because now you have a sample paper that is going to walk you through format, that's going to walk you through content, it's going to show you sample references and how to cite in-text citations. So all of that will be covered in these sample paper videos. So you want to make sure that you watch that as well. Secondly, inside some of my tutorial videos, and let me bring this up, I'm going to provide you some extra credit opportunities. Now these points will come in handy. This course has a midterm exam. Traditionally, students do, on the average, not so great on these midterm exams. They probably don't put in enough time that they need. So this is where these points will come in handy. So in some of these tutorial videos, I may give you a keyword, and I'll give you some instructions on what to do, and if you complete the task, you will receive those extra credit points. So here are some easy goals for you to be very successful in this course. Number one is to be visible, to engage, to communicate. As always, inside the course, you're gonna have multiple ways that you can send a question out to me, and we're gonna cover those over the next few minutes inside of this HALO tutorial. So, without further ado, let's go in through a walkthrough of our class inside of HALO. Okay, class, so when you land inside of your course, it's going to look something just like this. Keep in mind that some of the tabs that you might see on the left-hand side of the screen may not be visible to you because I am obviously in the instructor role and not the student role. But for the most part, everything will look just the same. So as you can see here, and I'm going to go ahead and grab a marker, up here you can see obviously the weekly calendar information. And if you go up here, you should be able to toggle between, you know, 1 week, 2 weeks, and look at all the weeks ahead. For this purpose of this video, I'm just going to keep it with the 2 week view so you can kind of get an idea how this looks like. So this is your calendar view. Now, if we go over here into this section, right, for example, if you want to go ahead and post in a particular item, in this particular case, the class introductions, DQ1 or DQ2, all you need to do is click on it right from here, and then you can see here that you should be able to go right to your discussion. It should look something similar to this. So when you click on it and you head over to the discussion, you can see here I've already posted my discussion here. So what you would need to do in this particular case is go right here and click on reply to discussion, and then you can go ahead and click on your reply. So you will always see the actual question up in the top, and then you will have a reply feature. So if we go back into this calendar, and I'm going to give you an example of a discussion question, you would click on the discussion, you would head over to the discussion board, and then you're going to note two things here. Number one is here's the actual question, and then here you're going to have an opportunity to reply to the discussion. Okay, so that's how you access the discussions right from there. Now, since we're talking about discussions, you also have an area right here that talks about the discussion forums. So right here, if we click on discussion forums, then this will bring up all of the actual discussion questions. So again, if I click on topic one, DQ1, then that's gonna also take me directly to the discussion area. So a couple of different ways that HALO allows you to access the information. So let's keep moving down the tab right here. Let's head over to the announcements section. So when you click on announcements, you're gonna see here that as of this video, I already have one posted announcement right here, okay? So this is an actual announcement that I've posted. Now, this is very important to remember, okay? Because all of my weekly intro videos and all of these sample paper tutorial videos will be posted here under the announcements section. I'm not gonna clutter up the calendar. I'm gonna post everything in the announcements. So as a student, you should be inside of the course. As you know, the minimum is 3 days a week per GCU policy. I hope you enter the course more than 3 days a week, but you always want to make sure that you check the announcements tab. You should see it visible, and that way you can access the course, okay? And as you acknowledge this, I'll get a check as to who has viewed and who has acknowledged the actual announcement. So this is where you find the announcement section. Right over here, if you click on this, you're gonna have the entire syllabus, okay? So here is my information, and then you're gonna have class resources. So if we click down on this, you're gonna have different resources. These resources are important because, for example, you're gonna have your ebook right here. You're gonna have a Lopes Right tutorial right here. As we complete the CLC projects, you're gonna have your peer evaluations form here. This is a very big one. Here is your study guide for your midterm exam. And as you scroll down, you also are going to have this CLC agreement, which is gonna be needed one time as we begin our CLC projects. So as you scroll down, let me click this off, you are going to have access to all the different topics right here. So again, drop-down menu, this also walks you through some of the different sections here. And again, it may look a little bit different from your section, but you'll be able to find the objectives and everything here that is due for that particular topic, including your assignment. But again, I will be giving you weekly videos on this, breaking down each assignment for you. And lastly, inside the assignment section, you can also find the rubric, which is always good to follow. So again, this will happen for every topic. And then as you scroll down, in case you're not aware where it's at, you want to make sure that you read these participation requirements, even though I will cover those again. But just as a reminder, okay, you will need to post or be in the course at least 3 days out of the week. And we'll talk more about this. I have another video on this. And you're going to have at least 6 peer replies. Okay, so if you are in the course 3 days and you're posting 2 peer replies, then that's going to be a total of 6 in addition to your mandatory classroom discussion questions. But again, we'll cover that. And then, of course, the letter grade information can be located here in this area under the syllabus. Okay, you can access your grade book. And again, it may look a little bit different, but your grade book will be in that section for your individual grades. Now, we've talked about discussion forums. I will be creating groups. And again, we have also this section called class questions. So this is a public forum. So if you wanted to ask a question, right, then you can go ahead and ask the question inside of this section here, and I will receive the response, okay? In this section up here, let me bring this up here just to show it to you. In this section up here, it's called messages. So if you click on messages, now that message is more of a private message. Okay, this is between you and me. No one else sees this message. So if you want to convey something private to me, then you would need to click on the messages, choose who you want to send the message to. In this case, it would be me. Okay, you can also message students directly. Okay, so again, that feature will be here under the messages. Okay, so I can't message myself, so that's why I don't see myself in the drop down menu, but you will have access to messaging me in this particular section. Okay, so that is the messages section. Okay, so as we head back to the, what I call the home screen, and again, going over to the left, you wanna make sure you look at this tab right here, and you've got class resources, another way to access what we already covered. So you will be using these forms, very important that you understand where to locate them. This is obviously an instructor only. And then here on the left-hand side of the menu, again, you're gonna find your topics. So if you click on topic one, you're gonna come up with everything that's due and required of you with due dates inside of each particular topic. And again, I will be breaking down each topic or each week for you in a separate video. As you further scroll down, when you need to use access to the library, you would click on that resource and it would take you directly to the library, especially when you are looking to conduct your research. Moving along, you're gonna have a Student Success Center down here. If you click on the Student Success Center, again, this is a great resource that can help you, especially with the writing process, APA templates, APA format, and all that good stuff you can find here inside of the Student Success Center. And there may be times where I may be referring you back here, especially if you don't do so well when it comes to APA and what have you. Then you've also got a tab called Learning Support. You've got classroom policies as well. So again, you can find all of that inside of this left-hand margin tab. So overall, that's an overview of HALO. If this is your first class, that's okay. Kind of get in there, navigate. You're not going to break the system and maneuver around. And as always, if you have any questions for me, if you want to ask the question publicly, then you will go ahead and use this class question section. If you want the class or you want your question to be private in nature, then you want to go ahead and use the messages tab. And that will be kind of like an email that will be just between you and I, and no one else will be visible. Okay, so I hope you got some value in this tutorial. Definitely hit the like button below if you did. That way, you know, other students can make sure that they see this, whether they're in my course or not other courses. And if you want to comment something below, then definitely do so. If you got some value and this helped you, just comment below, yes, this helped, and I would greatly appreciate it. Okay, so I will see you inside the course. Thanks for watching.